I guess we're back. It's been a year.
Oh, you're not even going to give the beautiful intro a fucking chance. You just kill it in its fucking infancy. I worked hard on this motherfucker.
Yeah, I'm pro-abortion now. That's my big personal change.
On that note. All right, guys.
We are already aborting the intro.
Yeah.
It sounds like an abortion is going on. What the hell? What did you put in the back?
They're seagulls, asshole. Are you not okay with seagulls?
Dude, seagulls. Give me nightmares, man.
Dude, when I go to the beach, I see seagulls and it's dope. Alright? So fucking deal with it.
Seagulls are vicious.
They are vicious. I've seen them fucking dive bomb people. I guess this is a yearly tournament now.
Yeah, we're doing the hunter approach.
You still run ads more frequently than majority of Halo.
Sadly, that's probably true.
It actually is. But in the last tournament,
didn't we constantly shit these kind of intros? Like all the first 24 seasons or whatever?
Oh, well, maybe you should have done the intro your damn self this time, motherfucker.
Oh my god.
Are you going to shit your pants? Are you going to shit your pants?
Did any of these obstacles change since the last tournament? Like, did we even need to do this?
We added a completely two new fucking obstacles, but yeah. We got rid of the Illuminati bullshit.
Yeah, that was my favorite part.
Well,
but the Illuminati kind of, they sued us for...
Yeah, the Illuminati...
pretending to be associated with them.
Okay, so we're doing a tournament now. It's been a while. We're out of practice. We forgot...
Is Swan's favorite color?
I don't know what color it is.
Exactly.
So, old...
disability shaming?
Drewski here is, getting on to the blue moon. This is a brand new obstacle, and
this used to not happen, I don't think.
What used to not happen?
This. Anyway, see, here's the new obstacle.
What are you talking about?
Look who's on the course right now, and he's not dead.
Yeah, he used to be like really fucking garbage, but now I guess he's like.
This is the turnaround.
Really fucking garbage.
Still kind of bad.
That was a horrible fail. Like, that was embarrassing. But I know that we're probably going to see 1,000 of those this tournament. And, I mean, the family probably should have been number one, but, okay.
I'm going to give Drew a spot. What taco? Which taco is this?
I believe this is Booker Taco. You know, like, the wild one? The one that, when you get in a party with him, he's like...
He's a reset the ball.
There we go. Booker Taco! Jesus Christ, dude, is he going to shit himself anymore? Is he going to shit himself
anymore? This isn't really an obstacle. That was just kind of there for show.
I love watching people fail the part of the obstacle that isn't the obstacle.
Yeah, those are like an intermission.
Oh!
He gets on the ball here. Never mind, no he doesn't. He is worse than Drew TV, confirmed.
Oh, dude, if you're worse than Drew TV, it's time to hang up the old Xbox controller. Here's Soul Reaper.
I forgot to change the sign there at the beginning.
I thought we were just gonna not talk about that.
Oh yeah. Yeah, we'll bleep that out. He's British.
I believe you overestimate how much effort I'm gonna put into this.
How much production value? We've already spent it all on that man can. It just felt like I fly on the fucking moon.
And the intro is what we spend all of our budget on. Everything else is just, he's...
Ooh, yeah. Well, actually, it didn't fail until he touched that red part there.
What is that? Fucking 3 blue balls / blue moon failures already? And then Bubba, like, who the fuck cares about him? And here's Cheese. Who the fuck cares about him? I love
that. He has 3 more kids since the last time we met him.
I love the first half of an Aborigines tournament where it's just, who the fuck cares about any of these fucking people? I'm sure they all have feelings and stuff. But, like, and Cheese on to the blue moon, and he flies
up to the blue
ball. You
gotta be a bit of a masochist to run this course, to be honest.
The blue moon, let's look at this on the fail cam.
Oh my god.
You can see he just gets entirely too much momentum and lands on the track without even getting a chance to touch the ball. Cheese just completely whiffs on the ball, and that is an outo-doubto for Cheezo. All right. On to Iris.
Was he really worth
it? No, but actually, let's look at that again. And what... let's just watch him. You see, he has the complete wrong angle on the blue. He comes down. He hits way too far forward on the trampoline. Hits way too far back on the moon. And flies like a fucking monkey all the way over the blue ball. And... you know, when I created this obstacle all by myself with no help from Ump Double Ump, this is exactly the kind of fail that I envisioned happening.
That is completely out of the contestant's hands.
Well, no, if he had hit it in the right spot, he would have been all right. What do you think about Cheese's horrific mistake on the blue moon?
God, dude, like, I don't know why we're validating this guy's fail by showing it anytime. He's gonna think he's part of the club now, just because we're roasting him so hard.
Oh, Jesus Christ, dude. He isn't in the place anymore, so... This
video's twice as long as it needs to be?
Yeah, this is why the video's, like, fucking 35
we're gonna have to upload this in two parts. This is gonna be the Cheese edition. And then just the rest of the turn.
Cheese, Aborigines cheese episode. And then the rest of Aborigines. Alright, yeah. You see that,
oh my god.
This is what you want to not do on this obstacle, ladies and gentlemen. Don't worry, I think I got the last one. I really think this is the last one. I'm really hoping.
Just, I'm pretty sure
if there's another one after this, this joke is about to be very not funny. Okay, we're on.
Oh my god.
But let's look at it! Okay, no. We're on that.
Jesus Christ, dude. Yeah, I honestly forgot we're running a tournament.
Yeah. Actually, Irish.
I went through several mental stages.
What if when Irish gets to the blue moon, it just like cut back to Jesus? Jesus Christ.
Oh, I thought he was going to go under with some jump awareness, awareness, but I don't think anyone's gone under yet. This is Aborigines. You're supposed to, go down under.
He sticks it on the ball. That was.
Oh, we're actually seeing someone attempt the obstacle, I think.
Yeah, he really leaned over to the left there, and oh my fucking god. When that fail happened, you know that somewhere he threw his controller through a fucking wall. You know that Irish just fucking lost his goddamn fucking shit.
Yeah, now there's two holes punched.
Dude, Irish is nice as hell until something slightly inconveniences him. And then he's like the fucking Hulk. Here we have TP Helix 1610.
I guess Caesar trying to read this guy's name.
Now he's colorblind, bitch. Alright, PP Helix is on to the blue moon. Doing some weird shit.
Get some side angle technique. Let's see how this goes.
Them damn Brits and their side angles.
He nails it, actually. Wow, that...
Yeah, he actually fucking
gotta admit, I was not
right
expecting that.
That was like probably... Oh, well, he ruined it. It's all gone. Fuck you, Vulcan.
The one time we actually gave him credit for something.
Now we have the Mandalorian.
The Mandalorian.
He was...
This is
a layered joke. I want you to really think on it for a little while.
Who is this?
I just want you to think on it for a little while. There's a... It's a layered joke. We'll come back to it. Here's Z-Master. He has Tiny Peen, and Tiny Peen is off the course. Maximilian Bazillion. Can you tell where I got bored in the editing process? All right, but luckily, we don't have to look at Maximilian Bazillion much longer. Cobra Kai never dies. He's
okay.
Through the first obstacle.
This guy.
So
I mean, we saw Drew do this, so that's.
I bet you're still wondering who the Mandalorian was. All right, Cobra Kai never dies onto the blue ball. He's rolling it down the track. Very solid technique here. Never.
Why does he?
And he's.
Okay.
Alright. That was pretty disrespectful.
He didn't
do that.
Fail
honestly.
It. He did not
he
fail
didn't
it.
Clear it, but he did not fail it.
I'm not sure if we can, I'll put like an asterisk on that.
I think we need to stop the run and have the judges decide what's going to happen. Alright, he's on to the ROG swing. Who is this kid, by the way? He fucks up the wrong swing horribly and embarrasses himself. But
I mean, Cobra Kai season 2 just came out, so I mean, there's a lot of anticipation for this run, as you saw there in the stands.
Well, season 3 just came out, you fucking imbecile, but he's good.
Oh, God.
Oh, fuck, dude. Oh, that was fun to watch, honestly.
Maybe stick to HBO.
If that motherfucker talks to me about the Playgate one more fucking time. And here's Joey. Recently, he has earned the title of at least number 2 most annoying kid on Xbox. Because holy fuck, this kid is the absolute fucking antithesis of everything that I like in my life. When I hear the notification that someone joined my party, and I look down and it says Joey Davis, I really want to fucking cut. You know? And I know that I like to joke around on Aborigines a lot, but I really feel passionately about this, and I really mean this with all sincerity.
Open your veins.
Joey Davis makes me want to cut myself with a rusty razor.
Oh, dude, I haven't had a good cut in a while, though. You
know? It has been a long time since I busted out the rusty razor and just sliced open some of those veins, you know?
You're throwing it back to the rusty razor.
Oh, yeah.
You're going to get a new one. You're going old.
But it looks like Joey...
Oh, anyways, he's on the Irish chest. Is Joey a little Irish, do you think? Irish descendancy.
Davis kind of...
The plane is like 9-11 all over again.
Joey's cleared the first stage. Yeah, that's Joey's first stage 1 clear, and we kind of didn't talk about it. On to Rog.
Was that his first run?
Oh, no, he's been on ads.
Look at my cheat sheet here. And Rog is okay.
Rog had a couple issues with the Matrix there, but he's on. He's starting to believe. Oh, we have 2 undercrouch techniques in a row, and... Absolutely the worst attempt we've seen on the Blue Moon so far. Thank you very much, Mr. Rog. You make me happy. Mwah. All right. This is no longer stepdaddy saying. We are far.
Oh, this is like when your mom divorced him and he's like, you know, drunk and
he like found that ditch somewhere. High school and asked to borrow some money.
Yeah.
Oh my god. Yeah, Sane's runs. Oh fuck, that one hurt to look at. Sane's runs have kind of turned into he could fail anywhere, and it's kind of just painful to watch because he's gonna fail in the worst possible fucking way. Just
manages to get on it. It's going to the left though.
Yeah, a little bit. Yeah, he never stood a chance. I'm not lending you money. All right, here is Mr. Alpha Puma. I believe he's coming off his 14th retirement, right? Or is he up to?
Yeah, he's trying to go for the all-time retirement.
Dude, he got the all-time retirements a long time ago. It used to be you with like 3, and now he's at like 15. So, yeah.
I mean, there's new music here. I'm kind of.
Are you just kind of jamming out? You want to just jam out for a second?
I think Puma cleared last tournament. He actually looked well, unlike now. Especially after that. Jesus Christ.
Oh my God.
You didn't replay that one.
Oh,
you replayed cheese 100 times. You think Puma does that?
Oh my God.
What?
Alright.
What is wrong with you?
Here we have Atlantic Champ. He clears sometimes, I guess. He's like the most boring kind of top competitor on ads. Like, he does good.
Oh,
sometimes.
Dude, he's always second fiddle, you know. He's that, you know.
He hasn't had a stage 3 since tournament 5.
See
you, bud. Get the fuck off the course. All right, right.
Yeah, I'm just glad we get to not talk about Atlantic anymore.
Dude, it's like a weight off my shoulders.
He was a guy at one point.
Well, if he spent more time practicing Ninja Warrior courses, he'd probably be the best out there. You see, I think Chris is probably the most under. Who do you think the most underrated jumper in all
I'm
of?
Not
jumpers?
Having this conversation.
I already have my answer, but I want to hear what your answer is.
I think it's answer, Drew TV after that first run there.
I'm my answer Drew. Is none other than Chris. He doesn't practice in Ninja Warrior as much, and I know he hasn't had much success on it.
Holy shit, he
have you
that.
Seen him on a jump map?
Well, I'm seeing him on this jump map.
Yeah, anyone who does shit like that is not. All right, here we have
Oh my
Smokey.
God, what is this?
You want to just jam out for a second, dude? You just want to like stop talking for a minute and just jam out for Lady Gaga? This is Lady Gaga, you fucking uncultured. Oh shit!
Oh my god!
I can't say that.
That might be an incident. We actually need post production.
Yeah, I might actually have to boot that one up. That is the most Smokey fail that he could have had. All right, here we have
God,
Fireball.
We're at number 22.
Fireball. When was the last time Fireball did good?
I think he did good last tournament, bro.
Dude, that was like a year ago.
Yeah, it's been a year.
Yeah, it was. There have been times where we like ran a tournament and then didn't upload it for like half a year. This time it was actually like we ran 24 like 2 years ago. Took a year to upload it. And then now we took a year to run and upload this one. Oh, Jesus Christ, dude. I'm drinking this Monster and I'm about to give you all sorts of gory details about how I am regretting it right now. I'm like burning.
Oh, dude, that's like that. But you that know, chalky like, cocaine.
Yeah,
you know?
Dude, it is. It's kind of chalky. Yeah. Yeah, you know, it's a little bit...
People who drink Monster Energy are those guys who are like... They go to like an AA meeting and are like, this is the one. This is the time. It's going to be better after this.
Well, I'm a little bit offended seeing his... Oh, that was a really high jump from Fireball. That was pretty good.
Yeah, it was a decent jump. And he clears, I guess Joey cleared.
Yeah, Fireball clearing is
we got two guys
the
now?
Most interesting thing to happen this tournament. Here we have Hunter. No, but dude, I'm a little bit hurt because I'm literally drinking Monster right now, and that's how this conversation started. And now you're like telling me about how much Monster's only drink by fuckheads. But I want you to know, I drink this Monster because I'm so dedicated to running this average in this tournament. I see what he tried to do, but he really
appreciate that.
All right, and Happy Days are here with Flamosaurus. How did he do in the last game? Like, I think he did.
Stage two? Remember
no,
during the,
Flame failed with Black people in the last tournament, dude.
He did well.
I'm pretty sure he did not.
I think in the Olympics. I think...
The post-production will say
what did he do
right.
in 24?
I'm pretty sure he failed the second
half. Remember tournament 24?
I think in 23... He failed the first obstacle.
Oh, Jesus.
And then in 24, he failed the second obstacle.
Yeah, he did fail the first obstacle at some point, so he's no longer perfect on first obstacle. It's just Puma.
Yeah, only Puma. There's a illustrious record for you.
My God, speaking of Puma, it looks like Puma on the fucking cheese wheel.
Yeah, this is Jesus a painful Christ. Cheese wheel run.
What's the time?
Flame is probably my least favorite person to watch jump ever. Because he looks like
God.
Such a fucking quivering pussy while he is jumping. He just looks scared of every fucking obstacle. And he just walks up to everything and almost shits himself. And just looks at it for like 5 seconds. And I can just hear him on his mic going, Sean, what do I do? But he clears.
Mr. Op, what's my time?
Mr. Op, what's my time? We haven't given a fuck about any clear we've had so far. We've had 3 clears so far. This is what, like Flame's 5th clear? That's a lot.
Sure.
I know it's been 25 tournaments, but you know. Alright, and here we have the guy. Last tournament he made it all the way to the fucking Chinese Lantern, did he not? Is that
canon? That one got wrecked on.
No. That was
the Olympic one?
No, that was Abs 24.
Oh,
it was
yeah.
in the video. All right, but he's on to the Blue Moon. He's never seen.
I think
this
he made it back
before.
In the Olympics, so he's got some good run of form here. Hopefully.
Okay.
Well, he's still alive.
No, no. Oh, actually, yeah.
He's still alive, yeah. Well,
okay. Okay. Yeah, you're right. You're right. Okay. Hope my fucking battery doesn't die here soon. Yeah, here are all the Blue Moon fails. It's a fucking lot. We had 18 attempts on it, and 13 of them bit the fucking dust. The slow-mo on Movie Maker is really bad, so it just kind of looks like a PS1 game.
Yeah, dude, it looks like Super Mario 64 at the beginning of the game. Oh my god,
this part might be
bad. Yeah, we've seen this obstacle 20 times, dude. Like, we don't...
Yeah, well, now you see it better.
We saw 13 people fail it.
Why can't you be grateful for what you get in this life? I'm double ump. You just have a little bit of fucking respect for this course that we put our blood, sweat, and tears into.
Dude, no one wants to see it. People, we got stage two.
Shut the fuck up.
This is very.
Okay, it went on a little bit too long. All right, we're on to stage two.
Oh god.
Oh my god, are you gonna shit your fucking pants? Keep that shit to yourself.
Is this necessary?
Oh, if you didn't like the stage one introduction, you're about to be very unhappy.
Oh, Christ. At least there's a jump cut. Oh. This isn't like those one takes, you know. You know, Hollywood's big on one takes these days.
Well, it was one take. I just cut it down because I love you.
You couldn't just fast forward it.
I don't love you that much. You can swear I got bored in this introduction.
The stage really doesn't look that good in daytime.
Oops.
Anyways, we're gonna Broadway Joe.
Yeah, it does look a little bit better at nighttime. We should switch it to nighttime. Broadway Joe, onto the course. He's onto the what's it fucking called? He's onto the other what's it fucking called?
And onto he's not Talking bullshit. King, so now he's on a real obstacle. Let's see.
Talking King is the only one who ever failed that fucking obstacle. Wait, did Talking King clear twice in Aborigines, or was that Halo Warrior?
That might have been H2.
Well. All right, here's Broadway Joe. He's on to the...
Atlantic likes to fail this obstacle, I think, but this isn't him. This is Joe.
Has anyone ever actually failed that obstacle?
Look at my cheat sheet here, and...
You don't have no fucking cheat sheet. Suck my...
Joe just goes for... He sticks the landing.
That was a big, fat jump that he just did, dude. Yeah, not a fan of him stopping on it. I still believe that stopping on the metal spin means that you have a tiny, tiny penis and an even tinier little fucking raisin-sized ball sack. And
he completely endos. Oh my god.
That didn't go well for him. Dude, this music's relaxing.
Has this guy driven a mongoose before?
Alright, well, if there's going to be anyone here who clears this stage, it's going to be Fireball.
He's the only one who's slightly competent in Mongoose's stuff, you know.
Well, he's the only one
who does that race league done.
Yeah. But also,
he's fairly okay with Mongoose obstacles.
Yeah. I think he's been.
He changed his armor, is he black? What's going on?
Hey. That's their word. Alright, he's
gonna say something. Anyways.
Some reason he's
Talking King Junction
duck walking everywhere.
Our retired hero, you know.
Yeah, Talking King.
Talking King.
Talking King, of course, the first inductee into the Jumping Hall of Fame.
This is the Puma metal spins. Oh Jesus Christ!
Don't even acknowledge that failure. Don't even fucking acknowledge it. Just pretend it didn't happen. It's better that way.
Forgot that happened.
I did too. I'll just kind of chill out watching the run. Failed the part of stage two, dude.
I mean, there's literally one jumping obstacle on this one.
Yeah. If you fail any obstacle on this stage, it better be this one. This is a...
Flames just...
What the fuck?
I'm not sure that's any easier, but he just does it anyway.
Yeah, I guess you can.
I guess because he can. He's enjoying his freedom. Yeah, I think freedoms are important. And Flame is, he's a patriot.
Well, is Joey pro Davis freedom. Gonna get a first place in this fucking tournament? Or is Flame gonna...
I don't see Flame alleged maybe in a retcon.
Yeah, I don't think he's ever been in an abs. He is taking the pussiest technique. And he does like 3 save jumps on him, dude. One. Okay, only
he
one.
He might technically get first place here because I don't see Flame failing his non-optimal part.
Well, if Flame lands that jump he's coming up on, then he will be in first place.
Yeah, like, I don't know how Joey does this. This isn't an obstacle. It's literally just a straightforward jump.
I believe that is Flame's first stage 2 first place. He had a first place. Oh, Jesus. He had a first place in Ad 6, I believe.
This is getting a little hard to watch. Getting a little hard to watch.
Hey, you put the poor kid on a mongoose. You knew this was going to happen. But he's...
The one guy we had who was decent at Among Us failed the battle spell. That was kind of what we get.
I'm pretty sure he's going to have to kind of...
Yeah, and he has nowhere near enough speed to get up the hill. He's going to stall pretty hard.
Well...
That is... Not what you expect.
Well, you all waited a year?
Yeah, I hope that was worth it.
Yeah, hope it was.
There's gonna be some heavy redesigns. Nowhere near enough first obstacle fails, so I decided to move the cheese wheel to the first obstacle.
It's gonna be a quadruple cheese wheel.
And then the rest of the stage is gonna be mongoose.
It's gonna be a 5-dimensional cheese wheel.
Yeah, you have to play 4D chess while going down the cheese wheel.
On one leg. No,
you have to use your other leg to play chess.
Yeah, I'd be careful with the redesigns because if you redesign too much, Irish is gonna boycott your course because it doesn't stay true
because
to the original
be...
spirit of Satsuki. And I really think
I was thinking because it'd be difficult for him to keep his spreadsheet up today.
Yeah. Well, I really do think that this course needs to start staying more true to the spirit of Satsuki.
Next tournament there's gonna be 100 competitors.
Yeah, 100 competitors coming in Aborigines 26, which is coming out tomorrow, the day after you're watching this. Abs 26 will be coming out. At some point, that will be true. That statement will be true. At some point, somebody will watch this tournament and listen to that. Sorry, I'm like mind fucking myself. Say goodbye to the lovely people at home.
I still want to know who this number 10 was.
Oh, I'll just let you get to it now. I forgot about that. I was gonna like sprinkle that in throughout the tournament and like give you little hints, but I completely forgot about it after like run 12.
I forgot who failed the first optional.
The suspense.
Almost there. Oh, okay.
You get it now?
I think I made a Pedro Pascal joke.
Yeah. I almost gave that joke away to you before we did it. I hope the build up for that joke after 20 minutes was worth it. I hope it.
I kind of forgot about it until I started seeing these names pop up.
Yeah. You know when you when you look at these results like this, it really
I feel like
makes
putting
you sad.
The Mandalorian kind of just deflects from how embarrassing Petrillo's fail was.
Or does it magnify it?
No.
Or does it?
Some Roblox kid's gonna be looking it up, be like, oh, Pedro Pascal did a run.
We're gonna go onto the Halo Jumping Wiki and it's gonna be like, yeah, they managed to rope in Pedro Pascal to do a fucking run on their course.
Now, allegedly, rumor has it, Pedro Pascal was little filled all along.
Oh, yeah? Dude. Did you see on that fucking Halo Jumping Wiki what they fucking put in the Mo Howard as?
Do I want to know?
They didn't call it the Mo Howard. They called it the Ledge Leaps. The fucking Ledge Leaps, dude. I've never been more offended in my fucking life.
Yeah, that's just blasphemous.
You don't fucking call it the damn Ledge Leaps. is called the fucking Mo Howard.
And we're still going. Oh, remember Snaz? Shout out Snaz, the only guy to fail the balance.
Maybe the only guy ever to fail a balance test. Yeah, I'll
there's
be, your attention span wasn't supposed to make it this far into the video.
Well, here I am. Oh, Chris. Chris failed the cheese wheel.
Maybe. Does the cheese wheel need to be harder?
Only, five people made it?
Dude, we had three.
And did Cobra
that's too
really clear it?
Yeah, I have one fair.
Well, I think it's plenty hard enough to be the first obstacle. Big enough cheese wheel. Man, looking at that one of the three on the metal thing, that's not something. I'm pretty sure there's more obstacles between the metal spin and the dragon.
I'm sorry, you want to go through all the fucking things and tell them about how we have 15 obstacles to do?
Bumper tribe.
Well, I was going to call it
you're complaining tribe, about people calling it the leaflet. You can't even get
it. I'm going to change it next tournament once I fucking forget what it's called. I just had to call it something. I wasn't going to sit there for like 3 hours coming up with a fucking name for it. Should have called it like Diddle Run or something. Oh, it's over. Okay, I guess we're done. Bye.